Hello everyone, my name is Roberto Del Amparo, a PhD student at the University of Vigo, and I am going to present my poster entitled Influence of Empirical Substitution Models of Evolution on Recombination on Protein Folding Stability. As we know, empirical substitution models are one of the most used tools in phylogenetics. Despite this, these models make important assumptions which can lead to the appearance of biases that affect the result of the estimates. In this work, we have focused on studying the influence of empirical substitution models, as well as recombination and substitution rate in terms of protein folding stability. The work is divided in three stages. First, a preliminary study of protein families. Next, we analyze the influence of the substitution model on the folding stability of proteins. And finally, we studied the influence of the substitution and recombination rates on the protein folding stability. For the first stage, 5 families of proteins downloaded from the PFAM database were selected. For the second study, the maximum likelihood phylogenetic tree was inferred with RUX-ML and G for each family of proteins. This simulation of protein evolution was done under the selected breastfeeding empirical substitution model and under the site-dependent SCS model implemented in Protein Evolver. In the third stage, we simulated the protein sequences evolution upon coalescent evolutionary histories with 6 different amounts of substitution and recombination rates using an empirical substitution model. The SCS model couldn't be applied. For the last 2 stages, the estimation of the free energy of the simulated protein sequences was performed with DeltaGRAM. The results are exposed in 3 important points. The best-fitting empirical substitution model generated unrealistic and stable proteins. Meanwhile, the SCS model generates protein sequences with stability much closer to the stability of the extant PDB protein. Under the most appropriate empirical substitution model, the increase in the substitution rate in the evolution of protein sequences again generated unrealistic and stable proteins. One more time, the SCS model showed protein folding stability close to that of the reference protein structure. At last, increasing the recombination rate led to increased instability of the developed proteins, but with a lesser effect than increasing the substitution rate. Once the experiments were finished, the following conclusions were drawn. The SCS models outperform empirical substitution models. Proteins evolved under empirical substitution models unrealistically increased their instability. Using SCS models, this phylogenetic bias in the modeling of proteins is much reduced. And recombination events produce proteins with a folding stability between the folding stability of the parental recombining proteins. Finally, thank you for your attention, and if you have any question, do not hesitate to write me to my mail. Thank you.